My name is Lindsey Curnutte, and this is On Air with Heritage Action, where we break down in 5 minutes or less how you can get involved today in the fight for conservative values.
Hi, I'm Thad, and this is On Air with Heritage Action. I'm filling in for Lindsey. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. has had an impact on advancing equality in this country. He once said, "The function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically. Intelligence plus character, that is the true goal of education." And this is exactly what we're seeing all across America, with parents fighting for the best interest for their kids. They want their kids to be taught to think critically, not forced to abandon thought and mindlessly affirm the tenets of critical race theory. However, as parents have fought for their kids, Biden's federal bureaucracy has targeted them. And this is a huge problem for the Biden administration. So just last week, we learned through FOIA requests that Biden's own education secretary, Miguel Cardona, contacted the National School Boards Association requesting a letter to be sent to the president that targets parents who voice concerns about education issues like CRT and labeling them as domestic terrorists. Now, this letter was sent to the White House, and President Biden later sent it on as a directive to his own Attorney General, Merrick Garland, to investigate these parents under the Patriot Act. Now, we know that parents aren't domestic terrorists, but we've seen an uptick in parents who are concerned about the divisive CRT curriculum being taught to their kids, reckless school closures because teachers choose not to go back to work, and the woke ideologies of transgenderism. Now, here's one Loudoun County parent who spoke out at a recent school board meeting last year.
CRT is racist. It is abusive. It discriminates against one's color. Let me educate you. An honest dialogue does not oppress. An honest dialogue does not implement hatred or injustice. It's to communicate without deceiving people. Today, we don't need your agreement. We want action and a backbone for what we ask for today, to ban CRT. We don't want your political advertisement to divide our children or belittle them. Think twice before you indoctrinate such racist theories.
One of these hotspots was Virginia. And parental rights actually served as one of the top issues in Virginia's recent governor's race, which helped secure the victory of Governor Youngkin, who defended the rights of parents to advocate for their children. Parents have been demonized by the Biden administration for simply defending their children from the woke rhetoric of teachers' unions and the left. Instances like this have inspired grassroots activists all across the country to take action by speaking out, running for their local school boards, and working with state lawmakers to pass legislation. Check out the links in our description for more information on this. A prime example of this is in Georgia. State Representative Brad Thomas recently introduced House Bill 888, which protects students and teachers from racial discrimination and compelled belief in racial essentialism doctrines or practices, including trainings and seminars that promote them. Students should be free to learn without being forced to affirm a personal belief in any political agenda. House Bill 888 also creates transparency by giving members of the public access to a list of school curriculum materials that are used in the classroom, things like books, articles, recordings, and web pages. Now, this transparency really does help keep parents in the driver's seat of their child's education. And this is just one of the many bills that are taking shape across state legislatures. So for this week, we want you to take action. Go to saveourschools.com so that you can learn more about ways to make an impact within your community and state by working with lawmakers to encourage similar legislation like the bill in Georgia to protect the rights of parents and students to keep politics out of education.
That's it for another episode of On Air with Heritage Action. Thank you for tuning in. Share this episode with your friends and be sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Rumble to stay in the know and up to date with Heritage Action. And one last thing, if you'd like to get updates on the podcast sent straight to your phone, text PODCAST to 51776. That's PODCAST to 51776.